it is disheartening to know that women's safety jumped from I think 11th to 10th or 10th to 9th, somewhere there's a jump, and we constantly hear that Delhi being an unsafe city for women, Delhi police keeps on taking number of initiatives for women's safety every year, new helplines, new applications. We are going more towards software side of it, about sensitizing our force personnel, bringing on more facilities in form of anti-stalking helplines, anti-obscene call helplines for women in Delhi, starting new helplines. We initiated with women help desks in all the police stations. We have public facilitation officers round the clock working in all police stations. So these are number of steps which Delhi police keeps on taking for ensuring safety of women. Having said that, today I realized in most of your survey, this cyber crime has, or information and cyber insecurity has emerged as the number one risk in almost, since from my policing experience also, most of the complaints which we receive from businesses are which are actually affecting them are all related to data thefts, impersonations, some phishing attempts, some calls, like some technical support person has called and evaded with has took passwords, has took usernames. There is a very common crime, I don't know if you have come across that. Especially for business entities who are dealing in international operations, who have their, whether they're importing or exporting, or who have their clients abroad, one fine day your client will call you or email you, rather a similar looking email. For example, if your client is xyz.com, there is a small change, it is xyyz.com, you'll receive an email from almost similar account, and he will send you his account details for that very you have to deposit this kind of money or for that deal which you had made, and as an unsuspecting customer, you deposit that money in a wrong account. Many times these incidents have happened. So we have many times we have received these kind of complaints from the business setup that they have transferred the money to wrong accounts because of an email which was from a similar looking handle. And in these incidents, the gangs which are operating are generally not based in India. These are international gangs who are based outside India, who have by any chance, because of not a very strong password, have accessed your email, have seen that you are dealing with this company, have in a way fooled you by sending that fake mail, and you have transferred a lot of money to it, and it becomes very, very difficult for us or for any law enforcement agency to get back, get that money back to you. It is very difficult now because a lot of money immediately, once it gets transferred to another nation from a third country and then for fourth country, and even if we try to freeze, we can only max recover part of the amount. We are unable to, I've never seen a case where this kind of transfer has happened when we have recovered. And in many such instances, you are not even getting claims from insurance also, because insurance also says it is your own fault. Similarly, talking about these kind of cyber threats only, or cyber crimes, there is a very common crime which is happening, is by way of a technical support call. You are being asked to share your personal identity, some PIN number or some number which like a very interesting case which I came across last week only. A person who is a gym owner of this area, he got a telephone call that I have enrolled in your gym and I want to pay your some 50,000 rupees. How can I pay? He said, okay, you send me an RTGS. The person again called, I'm trying to send my RTGS. Your bank is not accepting. There is some change in the system. I'm unable to pay. Why don't you give me your Paytm number? I will transfer the funds from my Paytm to your Paytm. So he said, okay, this is my Paytm details. Then he said, you know, I'm trying to send it. It's not, my money is not getting transferring. My money is not getting transferred in your account. You'll be receiving a small four digit or three digit some code in your mobile. You please give that, you know, code to me. That person shares that four digit of that information which he got in his mobile, and instead of he receiving some 50,000, around more than 1 lakh, 1.5 lakh was transferred from his account. And that though we managed to arrest all three of those accused persons, because they were also foolish, they purchased mobile phones from Amazon and they were being delivered to Meerut, and we got the information from Amazon, the address at Meerut, and where from there we picked all three of them. We received those mobile phones, you know, before they were delivered to that person. So these are the those, you know, from we as in Delhi police have also started a separate cell. You know, initially cyber crime was never perceived as to be a very big threat. It was a very small unit in an economic offense wing building in Mandir Marg.